Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I am going to be talking about math curriculum, and I'm going to be talking about why we changed from the Good and the Beautiful Level 4 to Saxon 5-4. So here we are talking about more curriculum changes. Are you guys actually surprised I was done making changes? I thought I was. I'm very shocked to be making this video, but I am because we have decided to change from the Good and the Beautiful Level 4 to Saxon 5-4. So before I go any further, I want to give a full disclosure that neither curriculum company is sponsoring this, as well as I love the Good and the Beautiful. This is nothing against their curriculum, and I'm going to explain that. We are still using their curriculum for language arts, and we're using their math for my other child. If you're new to my channel, I have three kids. I have a fourth grader, a second grader, and a preschooler. We have been homeschooling officially for 2 years, and we found the Good and the Beautiful a few months into our homeschool journey, and we really liked them. And their math was nothing but amazing, and so that is obviously why we started this year with it. But I just felt that their curriculum was not working for my older child. Now, with any curriculum, I don't think the perfect curriculum exists at all. And I think that one curriculum will work for one kid and it may not work for another kid. And my kids are completely opposite of each other when it comes to anything in any aspect. And so I also believe that your kids change as they get older. And the topic of math is just a difficult subject. Not saying it's hard for everyone, but it's a lot of work. And anytime I listen to anyone talk about their homeschool, math is always the non-negotiable. Math always has to get done. We're always focused on our math lesson. We do math first thing in the morning. That is what you hear everyone saying because it's a very important subject. And I think most people feel that way about math. So with that being said, the Good and the Beautiful math is super teacher friendly, especially once you get into level 4, because it gives video lessons. And so your child can watch the video lesson. There's also a lesson that if you want to work through it with them, or if they don't want to watch a video, that option is there. And so I loved it because it was very independent. What our struggle with it is maybe the reason that we love it for my other daughter, is it's beautiful, it has stories, it has art, it has a lot of fluff. And my second grader absolutely loves that. She loves the pictures, she loves the stories and all that extra that comes with it. Well, for my fourth grader, she just wants to learn what she's supposed to learn. She just is to the point. And so all that extra games and stories is really distracting to her. And she was taking a very long time to work through to even get to the problems because she was so just wrapped up in all the extras. She was learning from it. She was passing all her tests from it. And so it was hard for me to even think about changing it because I'm like, all right, you know, we can skip some of the games. But in my head, I'm like, well, if we're skipping the majority of what their curriculum is, then maybe this curriculum isn't for us. So I just kind of asked out on my Instagram. If you're not following me on Instagram, that is where I tend to just kind of do more day-to-day like questions, things I'm talking about. You'll normally hear updates sooner than here on YouTube. And so I asked out on my Instagram, you know, what math curriculum do you use and love? And I asked a couple follow-up questions from that. And I got an overwhelming response of Saxon Math. And I'm like, all right, you know, I'm used to a community that just praises the Good and the Beautiful. I want to say they were pretty much up there as well. And of course, lots of teaching textbook, but I just, teaching textbook is not for us. And so I was like, all right, let me watch some videos on Saxon because I've seen Saxon before and it completely overwhelmed me. I was like, I don't understand what their levels mean. Their books look insane. That's not for me, right? But when you get that many people telling you about a curriculum, well, it must be good, right? And so I started watching videos. There's not as many as I thought there would be. And it's really hard to find like sample pages online too that would really help you understand how it works. I had some really awesome people reach out to me on Instagram and they sent me pages, they sent me examples, they explained to me everything that you needed to know. I'm still the type of person though, like I need the curriculum in my hand and I need to actually work through it to understand how it works. So I did end up finding it used on Facebook Marketplace. That's where I buy all my used curriculum. The people had completed like one random lesson. Like it was weird. It wasn't even like the first lesson. It was like lesson 20. That was all that was done in all three workbooks. And so I got all three workbooks for like an amazing deal. So I was very thankful for that. And so I was like, all right, now that I have it, let me go through it. Now, if you buy just like the Saxon workbooks, it's not like the Good and the Beautiful where you can like scan a QR code, but they do have a couple options for video lessons. So I don't want to get super deep into Saxon. This is not like a Saxon review video. This is more me explaining why we switched. But I just want to let you guys know that I don't feel like I'm losing anything. So anyway, so with Saxon, there's like three different options for video lessons. At this time, I've decided to use Nicole the Math Lady. She was the most recommended for the video lessons, and we're doing a trial with her right now. And my daughter absolutely loves her, loves how the lessons are laid out, and so it just seems like a really good match for us. If you want me to go way more in depth on Saxon, do a lesson, explain how lessons work, how Nicole the Math Lady works, leave that down below in the comments. I will gladly do so, but this video would be way too long me talking about that. So anyways, so we're not missing out on the video independent aspect. I needed a curriculum for her that was still going to be independent. Not that I don't help her with math, but for the majority, I don't want to be teaching the lessons, especially as she keeps getting older. I do not want to be teaching algebra or geometry or calculus. That is just not for me. Now, my daughter is also getting older, and so there is a lack of information out there for older homeschoolers. I think it's becoming more prevalent because all the YouTubers' kids are getting older, or Instagram, or whoever socially you follow. So it's coming, but there is way more information for younger grades, and I think that's why The Good and the Beautiful gets so many videos, because I think that The Good and Beautiful is what I will use for my preschooler. I like the approach. I like the colorfulness of it, the beautifulness of it. But as we're getting into these older grades, I just felt like it was too distracting for my older child who really needs to start grasping these concepts. As well as, I really was kind of feeling like, because it is a spiral method, which I understand, they get introduced, they work on stuff they already learned, and it's like a, you know, a spiral approach. I feel like there wasn't enough review on certain things. And so that was a struggle, as well as I felt like the lack of teaching multiplication was pretty huge in The Good and the Beautiful. Now, I'm fully aware they have their musical multiplication. I didn't know that when we were doing level 3 that you needed to get that to really teach multiplication, but we did all of level 3 and it did not provide enough teaching on multiplication. It just didn't, and my daughter would not have liked musical multiplication. She would not have listened to those songs. To teach her multiplication, I had to use a supplement. And so that was kind of also playing into my mind. It's like, well, I was getting ready to buy more supplement books. But I'm like, but I don't want to do that. I want her to do a math lesson and be done. I don't want a supplement. I don't want all of this stuff. So anyways, I don't think that The Good and the Beautiful is lacking. I just think that it's not going to work for all kids. So With that being said, I think like musical multiplication, my second grader, as she starts ending her second grade, getting into her third grade year, she's gonna love that. That's right up her alley, and I think that's gonna work perfectly for her. But for kids that are more black and white, they want it straight to the point, I really like the Saxon approach. Now, it is not beautiful by any means. It is black and white. It is words and problems, and that is about it. The lessons that Nicole, the math lady, teaches, they are up on a whiteboard, and she is up there writing just how a classroom would be. There are no frills, no distractions. And so, yes, you might open it and be like, oh my gosh, we need color. Well, that's great. Some kids need color and all of that. But for us, it was, my daughter was able to just focus. There's actually, I want to say, more problems in Saxon, like more practice work to do than in The Good and the Beautiful. But because it's just straight questions instead of like this whole story and you have to like figure out all these things, it's just more straight to the point. She's able to work through it quicker. With The Good and the Beautiful, she would do her independent review, and then I had the answer key, and I would go through and grade it when she was done and then make her fix them. Well, with Saxon, there's kind of two parts to it that I like. One is just in the textbook itself, when they're working through their practice problems, and it's kind of big, so it's going to be hard to show you. Let's go this way. Okay, so this is question number one. So she's going to read question number one. Right next to number one, there's a smaller number, and it says 52. That is the lesson that that concept was taught in. So they are still a spiral method, and they are doing a practice from previous lessons. But what I love is when my daughter doesn't get it right, or maybe before she even tries to answer it, she's just like off the bat, like, I don't know. She knows that that is the lesson that it was taught in. So she will flip back in her book to that lesson, and she will do the review, and it will either instantly click in her head, like, oh yeah, that's what perimeter means, or that's what this means. And she's able to solve it. Or if she's not, she can work through it again and find that answer. So that is something I really like, because I do remember her in her Good and the Beautiful lessons, she would try to do that. She'd be like, oh, I know I learned this, but she didn't know what lesson it came from. And so she'd be skimming through all of her pages, where this just flat out tells you this was in this lesson. And it's true. I've watched her do it multiple times, and it's right there exactly where they say it's going to be, and she can figure it out. So that's just in the Saxon book. Now with Nicole the math lady, you actually enter in your answers on her website, and you get an instant grade back. And so my daughter will do problem number one, submit her answer, and then it will tell her if she's right or wrong. That instant like gratification of getting it right, I think, builds up that confidence. It gets them excited. Or if it's wrong, it right then and there, she knows she needs to go correct it, instead of doing 20 other problems and then having to go back through and figure out which ones are right or wrong. It gives us that instant, is it right or wrong or not. With Saxon though, you also get a third, like, work, you get three workbooks. One of the workbooks is a solutions workbook that you can actually do that same concept where your kid can just go grade themselves, or you could grade them. But I like the Nicole Math Lady approach because it's digital, it's record keeping, all of that. Also, another cool thing is it will tell me as her grade how many she originally got right. So, okay, it will say she originally got 80% right, and then after she corrected it, she got 100% right. So it's really cool to see that too. Like, did she just fully miss this concept, or was it just a one-off? Has it been working better? As well with Saxon, there's a lot more like tests involved, and knowledge checks and like fact practice. And that's just, I think, something that my kid needs to be better at math. We haven't been doing it long enough to really know the concepts covered, but I do feel in the lessons that we've done, it goes deeper into things than The Good and the Beautiful does, as well as their curriculum is all the way through high school, where The Good and the Beautiful is not through high school yet. And so that was another part of my decision. At this point in time, I want to say maybe math goes up to sixth grade, I haven't seen or heard of them having any plans to go further than that. Because they've already made changes to their curriculum, if they come out with, we'll say, high school math, well, we're probably going to be one of the first ones to use that. I don't really want to be a guinea pig on new math curriculum. That's just not something I think that we should be testing and trialing in those high school years. And so Saxon has been around for a very long time, and they have very in-depth math programs. Like I said, they get all the way up to different types of calculus for high school levels. And they're tried and they're true and they're proven to work. And so just knowing I'm going to have to pick a different math curriculum eventually for my kids, like I'm going to have to change it. There's not, the Good and Beautiful doesn't have that option right now. And like I said, I don't really want to be a guinea pig for math curriculum. I felt more comfortable too, like I'd rather switch her now and get her in the habit of this type of math, especially so she's not missing those concepts that are being taught, and then she's prepared to move on, and she's going to be doing like a pre-algebra in middle school and preparing for those high school levels. In all of that, I felt very confident in my decision to change, but ultimately it was up to my daughter. I didn't have, as much as I have a lot of valid reasons for switching, it wasn't a make or break situation. I was completely fine finishing out this school year using the Good and the Beautiful, and maybe thinking about changing next year. But after doing just even a couple lessons, my daughter really liked it. And I've seen her frustration go down. And that is not to say that Saxon is any easier. I've had multiple people tell me that Saxon is takes longer, it's more rigorous. And even with all of that, my daughter is less frustrated because she likes to the point, this is how you do it and this is the answer. And so I'm happy that she wanted to switch and it's working for her, and we now have a solid plan. That's it. We changed our math curriculum. And yeah, I haven't made any decisions for my other kids. Like I said, I don't have any plans on changing them. They are, well, my preschooler, he's not doing any specific math. He's just doing the Good and the Beautiful preschool. But I have plans for him to do K from Good and the Beautiful when he's ready. My second grader is doing fantastic. I think what I'll really be paying attention to is how in her second grade level, so level two, seeing kind of how that goes, getting the musical multiplication, seeing how that goes. And then we've already done level three. So I'm kind of just seeing how are all of those gaps going to get filled. And then we'll kind of make that decision. If I feel like she's missing stuff and I'm seeing my older daughter getting those things, then she may have to switch. And that's just going to be an educational choice because I want them to have the best possible curriculum that they can have. So that's it. There you go, guys. But again, nothing crazy. We're not completely jumping ship on the Good and the Beautiful. I just felt like this was a good choice. And I really do appreciate all of you that had reached out to me on Instagram and shared your stories. I know some of you switched from Saxon to the Good and Beautiful, and you had your reasons for that. And that also helped me in making my decision. So if you guys want more information on Saxon and actually to see how a lesson works, because I 1000% was overwhelmed when I first looked at it, but now honestly it's almost in the same format of the Good and the Beautiful. So if you know how to use the Good and the Beautiful, Saxon is nothing crazy. But I would love to share more on that and Nicole the Math Lady. Thanks so much for watching today's video, guys. I hope you have a wonderful day and we will chat soon. Bye.